It is Friday night, January 13th. We welcome you to Midland High School. It is time for girls basketball on MPS-TV as the Midland High Chemics play host to their crosstown rivals, the HH Dow High Chargers. It's a great night for high school basketball as we welcome you inside Midland High School. Jason Harper alongside Tom Bell for tonight's contest. And we start off, Tom, with a great contest here between the Chemics and the Chargers. Two teams coming in with extremely positive records. Two teams coming in with momentum on the season. The Dow High Chargers coming in with just one loss. Midland High only two losses on the season, and this should be a tremendous game.
And they've been waiting for this matchup for a long time. They really, I don't believe they've got any common opponents. Midland High has had the experience of playing a very strong heritage team for one of their losses. Dow hasn't played them yet, but this is going to be a great game tonight. Five players that see an awful lot of playing time are going to go head-to-head with each other.
Absolutely. The Dow High Chargers coming in under head coach Kyle Tyson, and the Dow High Chargers only one loss, and that's to a very tough Detroit Country Day team. In fact, this Dow High Charger team is picked to be one of the top teams in the state of Michigan when the rankings come out. And let's take a look, Tom, at your keys to victory for the HH Dow High Chargers.
All right. Kaylee Wasco needs to at least touch the ball on most possessions. This will give the guards a chance to maneuver on the arc. It also give Kaylee some shot opportunities early in the game. Don't let Van Sumeren, that's Alex on the Midland side, set her feet. If she gets comfortable on that three-point shot, she's very effective. And stop is Skylar Howard in the paint. Very athletic center.
On the other side, Elaine Mahabier and the Midland High Chemics. Only two losses on the season. One was the opening night to Freeland. The other one was to Saginaw Heritage. The keys for Midland High.
Yeah, they've got to avoid foul trouble. Their bench is not very deep. They just have three players. They need to share the ball offensively. They've got a lot of girls who like to score, and they need to stretch that Dow's defense so they can get some opportunities inside the paint as well as on the arc.
A little outside inside may be the key for the Midland High Chemics. We are getting set for high school basketball here on MPS-TV. We've got a great crew of MCTV staff and volunteers, and here we go. Let's turn things over now to our public address announcer, Jeff Yoder.
Thank you.
football here on MPS-TV, a production of MCTV. Jason Harper, Tom Bell, and a great staff on hand for the contest here tonight on this Friday the 13th. The Midland High Chemics and the Dow High Chargers. And one thing that these two teams share in common, Tom, is that neither team have a very big bench.
No, each team has three girls that each coach can look over to. So foul trouble is going to be huge. You know, they can't do a lot of experimenting on what the officials are going to call and what they're not. And when they get an idea, they got to live by it.
Now the Midland High Chemics without two of their starters, both Sadie DeWeld and Jaden Williams out for the season with different injuries. Sadie DeWeld dealt with a shoulder injury, Jaden Williams with a leg injury, and we are off and going with this game. The Midland High Chemics controlling the ball, and the first shot of the game into the paint by Skylar Howard is no good. Battle for the rebound, and we're going to have a jump ball called. Quick start of the game as we take a look at our starting lineups. The Midland High Chemics with Jordan Phillips, Alex Van Sumeren, Hannah Smith, Skylar Howard, and Maddie Berry. Dow High countering with Ellie Taylor, Nadia Atten, Molly Davis, Maisie Taylor, and Kaylee Wasco. A lot of talent on the floor for both of these teams. That's Ellie Taylor working the ball over to Molly Davis, and a travel as the Chargers turn the ball over. The officiating crew, a veteran crew on the floor tonight, Randy Hutton, James Lakely, and Sarah Sawyers are the men and women in stripes for the game tonight.
And Dow is seeing, Midland is seeing a little bit of a diamond press half court. They were able to break pressure quite easily.
Alex Van Sumeren working inside to Howard. Now they go back out to Berry. The three-point shot no good. Howard with the rebound. That put back is no good. And the Dow High Chargers coming up with the rebound. Chargers looking to press down with Maisie Taylor. Hands it off to her sister, Ellie. Ellie is the senior. Maisie is the sophomore of the Taylor sisters. Working inside now to Kaylee Wasco, and a nice pass by Wasco, but Maisie Taylor unable to complete the bucket, and the Midland High Chemics will come back the other way. Scoreless in the first minute, and inside the paint, the first foul will be called as Hannah Smith powers up inside, and Smith will take a trip to the free throw line.
Well, both teams have gotten a lot of good shot opportunities inside, but you know, this game has a lot of emotion at the beginning, and I like the way Hannah went right at Wasco.
First bucket of the game comes from the free throw line. Hannah Smith is a junior for the Midland High Chemics, coming off a great game last Friday against Davison. Both free throws are good. Neither team has played in a week due to the weather we have had recently. Working inside to Kaylee Wasco. The turnaround shot is good. Chargers tying it up as Wasco gets her first bucket of the night, and then Midland High throws the ball away. Miscommunication by the Chemics. Early on in the game, 6:36 to play here in the first quarter. Dow High working the ball to Ellie Taylor. She's a candidate for Miss Basketball on the high school circuit. We'll talk about her as this game progresses. Couple of dribbles now at the top of the key by Molly Davis. Works it back to Ellie. Ellie looking to go inside to Wasco again. The shot no good. Battle for the rebound is going to be brought down by Hannah Smith. Outletted to Alex Van Sumeren, who goes ahead. Midland's got the numbers advantage. Three-pointer no good. Rebound is going to be kept in play briefly by Midland High, but the Chargers on transition. This is where Dow is very tough. Ellie Taylor onto the paint, works it back out. Molly Davis is going to give it to Kaylee Wasco. Wasco will work back out to the top of the key. Three-point shot, Maisie Taylor, no good. Neither team shooting especially well in the first couple of minutes of this contest. It's a 2-2 game at the 5:40 mark. Three-pointer, Alex Van Sumeren, shot is no good. Rebound brought down by the Dow High Chargers. Nadia Atten will bring it back the other way. Long three-pointer, Ellie Taylor. That shot bounces around, goes out of bounds, and it'll be Dow High basketball.
Yeah, unfortunately, both Hannah Smith and Skylar Howard were battling for the same rebound, and it went off one of their hands. But we've got Alex Van Sumeren has drawn the attention of Ellie Taylor. Alex is a good defender. Ellie is a superior offensive player.
Looking inside, Ellie Taylor with the shot, no good. The battle for the rebound. Kaylee Wasco's gonna have it briefly. Goes out of bounds, will remain Dow High basketball. 5:18 to go. We are tied 2-2. The Dow High Chargers with the basketball. Ellie Taylor working it back out over to Molly Davis. Davis ends up going inside. Nice spin move by Kaylee Wasco, and a great job defensively by Skylar Howard, able to block Wasco from getting any shot. Midland High, Alex Van Sumeren, three-pointer, count it! And that is a big three-pointer as Alex Van Sumeren, with that three-pointer, has just set the Midland High school record for most three-pointers in her career.
That is 151, and she surpasses Jess Walter.
Allie Taylor answering down on the other end for the Dow High Chargers. 4.5 minutes to go, 5-4 in favor of the Midland High Chemics. Inside Howard with a nice dish, and the bucket by Hannah Smithy Jr. with the basket. Now Dow High on the other end, and a nice block. Skylar Howard with the block, but a foul's gonna be called. I believe the foul is going to be on, we'll wait to see who they called it on.
Was that Maisie?
It was. No, they called it on Kaylee. They called it on Kaylee Wasco. So that's the second one for Wasco, who will head to the bench for the Dow High Chargers. Ooh. Dow High bringing Asia Blanton into the game.
That may change the complexion of this game fairly early.
Early foul trouble. There's a nice defensive move by Nadia Atten to give the Chargers the ball back. On the other end, Molly Davis thought about the three. Chemics quickly on the defense across to Maisie Taylor. That three-pointer is no good. Rebound by the Chargers into the paint. Bucket by Taylor is no good. Battle for the rebound. Skylar Howard will get it, but double-teamed by the Chargers, and away the green and gold get the basketball back. Both teams having a hard time getting their offense going. It almost seems like a pickup game.
Well, it seems like the defense is a little random underneath the basket, and they're standing in passing lanes where Midland High isn't expecting to see them. But right now, there's still a lot of nerves in this game.
Bounce pass goes inside to Skylar Howard. Now working it back out. Three-pointer by Van Sumeren is no good. She's going to get another chance. Three-pointer, that one is no good. Battle for the rebound, and it's going to be Van Sumeren again. No good. The Dow High Chargers coming away with the rebound. 3 minutes to go here in the first quarter. 7-4 in favor of Midland High.
They're not setting any records for shooting percentage so far. Both teams have gotten some good shots, though.
Allie Taylor driving in. She went through three Chemics and able to come up with the basket. Allie Taylor will be playing college ball in St. Louis come next year, but she's looking to leave a mark in Michigan this year at the high school circuit. Three-pointer, count it from the corner. Maddie Berry, she is just a junior for the Midland High Chemics, has a nice three-point shot, and Midland High has a four-point lead.
Maddie is a very confident shooter, and she missed two on the last possession and was willing to kind of work herself into that shooting mode.
Four-point Midland High lead, just over 2 minutes to go. Molly Davis, three-pointer, no good. Rebound by the Midland High Chemics. Neither team really doing much to set up offenses. Both teams looking to fire the ball up quickly. Maddie Berry working it over for a long three-pointer, count it. Jordan Phillips is just a freshman. She wasn't expected to see as much playing time as she is, but due to injuries, she is making the most of that, and Phillips hits a three-pointer. Midland's got their biggest lead of the game.
That was a nice shot.
And we're gonna have a foul called on Van Sumeren. That's gonna be the first foul against Midland High.
Well, we have Asia Blanton into the game right now, and I know that earlier in the week, Dow's coaches were not sure how much time she would get. She was on a concussion protocol.
She was cleared yesterday to play as Ellie Taylor hits the three-pointer for the Dow High Chargers. So as Asia Blanton is in the game for the Dow High Chargers. Midland High putting a couple of new faces into the game. Sammy Van Sumeren and Jenny Gwinnis is both playing now for Midland. This is Sammy working the ball over, and Maddie Berry, three-pointer, no good. Rebound is going to go out of bounds. He'll stay Midland High basketball.
Now, Asia Blanton, Dow loses about 3 or 4 inches in height at center, but she's a tough one inside. She, defensively, she's very smart in there.
Gwynn McCaffrey checks in for the Dow High Chargers. Sammy Van Sumeren is a sophomore, the younger of the Van Sumeren sisters. Alex with the ball briefly, works it over to Maddie Berry. Berry goes back to Alex, now works over to Sammy. Sammy's still developing that three-point shot, but when she has a chance, her three-point shot's not bad. Midland's got a lot of players that can shoot that ball from outside of the arc, and the Chargers will throw the ball away.
Well, other than Howard, they really don't have an inside presence as such. It's developing. You've got Hannah that's been impressive, Hannah Smith. But their bread and butter is getting easy shots inside and really looking for the three-point shot on the arc.
Midland High with the ball in the corner, goes inside. Quick pass for Midland High to Hannah Smith, but she's going to be blocked. The Chargers play in the paint very well, and Ellie Taylor will come down. 15 seconds to go in the quarter, and Midland will steal the ball away. Nice job by Alex Van Sumeren. Van Sumeren bounce pass over to Maddie Berry from the corner. Shot is no good. 8 seconds to go. Chargers have time. They don't have to rush. They go down court. Molly Davis did rush, and the ball goes out of bounds. Chargers will have 1.9 seconds, which is more than enough time to get a shot off.
Yeah, they may run some sort of an isolation or a long bomber.
They could have Taylor launch a three. And the first quarter comes to an end here at Midland High with the home team Chemics leading the Dow High Chargers by a score of 13-9 as we have a chance to catch our breath here in the MPS-TV broadcast booth, and we'll have a chance to remind you how you can become involved in MCTV. This show is produced by volunteers, and the next training session is going to take place on February the 11th. The cost is $45, which includes the annual access user fee. For more information, call 837-3474, or just stop on by the MCTV studio located in the basement of the Grace A. Dow Library, or you can follow us on Facebook. Again, the orientation coming up on February 11th. And while we have a moment time, we do want to send our congratulations to the new MCTV manager, Matt Richardson, receiving the promotion recently from the city of Midland. So he is now to be referred to as Mr. Bossman.
Or Imperial Grand Poobah.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
He's liking that one. He's waiting for the t-shirt.
Second quarter off and running. Midland High with the basketball and the lead. Working down into the corner. Nice pass there, looking for Sammy Van Sumeren cutting inside. And Midland High coming up with the ball. Skylar Howard has played nice defense in the early portion of this game. Sammy Van Sumeren, three-pointer, no good. Battle for the rebound. Midland High comes away with it.
Other than Ellie Taylor, Dow seems a little unsettled.
Alex Van Sumeren, three-pointer, no good. Rebound by the Chargers as Maisie Taylor will bring the ball down. And again, Skylar Howard on the defense for the Midland High Chemics. Sometimes the information that doesn't end up in the box score makes a difference in the game.
It does, and I think that Midland High's been a little better interior passing, and they set up for a nice outside shot, and they've been getting some offensive rebounds too.
Midland High's had a ton of three-pointers. There's the transition that Dow High's been looking for, and Molly Davis able to put the bucket in. Midland's had numerous shots, but the transition is something that Elaine Mahabier was concerned about, and she calls a 30-second timeout to talk things over First timeout of the contest as the Dow High Chargers end up pulling within two. And when we talked to Elaine earlier today, Tom, that was one of her concerns. Obviously, she knows Dow High's got a ton of talent, but she wants to make sure the transition game is not strong for Dow.
And Kyle Tyson was very happy with the improvement of his three guards. He starts really with three guards, puts Ellie off more as a forward, but they work the ball well and they run the court exceptionally well. And that was really the first point by anybody that wasn't named Ellie Taylor or Kaylee Wasco.
And Kaylee Wasco is still on the bench for the Dow High Chargers. She picked up two quick fouls in the game. Alex Van Sumeren working the ball over to her sister. If you missed it earlier, Alex Van Sumeren setting a Midland High record for most three-pointers in her career, hitting number 151 in the first quarter. It's been her only basket of the game. Skylar Howard inside. The Chemics taking the time to set up their offense, and it worked nicely as Howard able to get her first bucket of the contest.
Howard was able to pin the Dow defender away, and they lobbed the ball over. It was a great pass.
Maisie Taylor, three-pointer. The sophomore left alone, able to hit the three again to make it a one-point game. Both of these teams match up so well. The Dow High Chargers, the Midland High Chemics, they both have players that will be playing at the college level next year. Dow High getting some attention from the state in the terms of rankings, but the Midland High Chemics definitely can hold their own. Only two losses on the season, one of that to Saginaw Heritage, which is another team getting a lot of attention in the rankings.
And they lost to Freeland to begin the season.
Sammy Van Sumeren, three-pointer, top of the key. The younger Van Sumeren extending Midland High's lead.
But Freeland's got a lot of athletes. They brought in about 13 players. Just kind of wore down the Chemics on their first night of the season.
Well, and Midland was juggling, trying to put players in new positions due to the injuries to Sadie DeWeld and Jaden Williams. So
exactly.
You know, what Midland High thought they would have in October is not what they have on the floor here in January. Three-pointer, count it for Dow High. Asia Blanton, the senior, hitting the three. Known more for an inside player, but she can hit the three-pointer as well. Inside to Skylar Howard, now working back out for Midland High. Hannah Smith, shot no good, out of bounds, and it's going to be Midland High basketball as Nadia Atten checks into the game for the Dow High Chargers, and Jordan Phillips comes back in for Midland High. Jenny Grenwis also is going to check into the game. With the exception of Kaylee Wasco, there's only been three fouls in this game. Two of them just happened to be Wasco.
Yeah, and Kyle's got to decide how many minutes in this first half he wants her to play.
Well, Wasco's been on the bench for quite some time. Chargers coming up with a turnover. There's the transition. Molly Davis. If she makes a habit of laying the ball up on the transition, the Dow High Chargers may have the advantage. In fact, Dow High takes their first lead, 19-18.
And she's got a very nice spin off her hands onto the backboard. Yeah, if they give her that much time, she'll have 30 before the night's over with.
Midland High working the ball around the perimeter. Jordan Phillips over to Alex Van Sumeren. Dow High has changed up their defense a little bit. Van Sumeren, three-pointer, no good. Battle for the rebound is going to be on the floor, and the jump ball possession arrow will be in favor of the Chargers.
And that was Jen Grenwis. She's seeing a little more playing time tonight. It's trying to give some Midland High's players a breather.
Paige Messick has checked in for Dow High. All of the dressed players for the Chargers have played here in the first half, and we've got an offensive foul called against the Chargers. Moving screen called on Quinn McCaffrey. 1 point Dow High lead, 3:45 to go in a fast-paced first half of girls basketball here on MPS-TV. Looking to work in the corner. Now they go inside. Skylar Howard can't get the layup to go. Everything but the bucket for Howard.
She had a nice lane to the basket and went left. Thought that was going to drop.
Ellie Taylor is going to travel.
Yeah, she looked up and saw that there was no shot and took an extra step. Well, it's been as close as we thought it would be. We're looking at the Chargers 19, Midland High 18. And really haven't seen any team really run off a lot of consecutive points yet.
Midland High slowing the pace of the game down a little bit. Long three-pointer by Maddie Berry. Midland High has been able to shoot three-pointers nearly every possession. Ellie Taylor with a three-pointer. That one is no good. Taylor able to get her own rebound, and a reach-in foul is going to be called. That, my friend, is why you follow your shot.
Exactly, yes.
The foul is going to be called on Maddie Berry, which is her first. And now we've got a timeout called. Elaine Mahabier is going to use her second timeout of the game, stopping the clock with 2:54 to go here in the second quarter, with the Dow High Chargers on top 19-18. And Tom, if you take a look at the Midland High huddle, and you look at the Dow High huddle, one of the things that I've noticed is the three-point shots from Midland High have been there all game long. They haven't made very many of those three-pointers, but if those start falling, Midland High can get some quick points in a hurry.
And when you're playing at home, and especially if they can get the crowd involved, I mean, you can really juice up your team and nailing a couple threes, and you can put Dow at a big disadvantage. But right now, Dow's been doing a good job in making Alex Van Sumeren give up the ball on the three, or maybe hurry the three. And that was one of our keys to victory, was to make her feel a little uncomfortable. But Howard's missed some pretty high percentage shots inside, but Dow's defense has gotten them here. And so there's a lot of pressure once you drive the lane.
And Kaylee Wasco remains on the bench for the Dow High Chargers.
We may not see her till the second half.
Interesting call by Kyle Tyson. We'll find out if it's beneficial. Wide open. As the Dow High Chargers, Molly Davis, the sophomore, one of the leading scorers in this game. She's got 6 points. Ellie Taylor's got 7.
But she hasn't made a shot further out than 1 foot.
Sometimes that's all you need.
That's all you need.
Alex Van Sumeren with the basketball for Midland High. 2:25 on the clock here in the first half. Chargers with the lead. Van Sumeren being guarded very nicely by Nadia Atten. Van Sumeren, three-pointer, count it. Second three-pointer of the game for Alex Van Sumeren. She's got 6 points for the Midland High Chemics. We're tied up at 21. Maisie Taylor, three-pointer, count it. And a nice job there by Molly Davis of driving Midland's defense back, and that left Maisie wide open, and Taylor able to hit the three.
Maisie looks a lot more comfortable this year in shooting that shot.
Foul's going to be called on Dow High's Quinn McCaffrey. That may be 2 on her. So the Chargers with 4 fouls between 2 players. And Ellie Taylor will come back in after a very quick break. Molly Davis will take her first break of the game.
Sometimes for players, it's a good time to take a look at the court without being on it.
Almost nice defense there by Maisie. Nearly came up with the steal. 1:42 to play here in the first half. 3-point game. Girls basketball here on MPS-TV. Also this weekend, boys basketball and wrestling coming your way. A busy weekend of athletics here on MPS-TV.
Dow is using the zone, just trying to buy time with Wasco on the bench. But Howard's been left fairly open on the inside, if they can just find her.
Like that?
Like that.
Skylar Howard with the bucket for the Midland High Chemics, her second basket of the game. A minute to go here in the half. Back and forth, these two teams have battled as anticipated. Ellie Taylor working over to Maisie. Macy goes back to her sister. Ellie with the ball, takes the screen set up by Nadia. Three-pointer, no good. Rebound pulled down by Nadia Atten, and a jump ball is going to be called as Atten and Alex Van Sumeren battle for that basketball.
Well, I think Midland High won on that. I thought Alex could have gotten called for a foul pulling Atten down, but I think the jump ball happened first.
40 seconds on the clock. The Midland High Chemics with the ball. There is no shot clock in high school basketball, so Midland could wait for the final shot if they choose to do so. Dow High has fouls to give. Both teams have fouls to give. A very clean first half of basketball. Inside they go, but Atten with a nice piece of defense. Now they go back to Howard. Skyler Howard, back-to-back basket for the Midland High Chemics, and Midland regaining the lead. 10 seconds to go for Dow. Molly Davis with the basketball. Davis taking a couple of dribbles, looking for the screen. Clock down to four. Davis will shoot the three-pointer. No good. Howard will get the rebound for Midland. Ellie Taylor will not count. But good hustle by Ellie at the end. And we have reached halftime here at Midland High. And Tom, this is just what we had hoped for. Back and forth and a great first half of basketball. A one-point game at halftime.
Yeah, this is everything that we thought it would be. These girls know each other very well, growing up in the programs throughout the years. Dowell kind of lost track of Howard at the end. And I think that Midland was great in getting the ball. For Dow, they're getting a lot of points that quarter from Molly Davis and Maisie Taylor. Ellie was left scoreless in that quarter. I think Kyle took her out, just trying to get her to calm down, take some better shots.
Now, two great coaches will come up with some halftime adjustments here at the half. We'll take a quick break, come back, and get ready for quarter number three. The Midland High Chemics leading Dow High 25-24. You are watching high school basketball on MPS-TV. We are back at Midland High as the teams take the court, preparing for the third quarter high school basketball here on MPS-TV. Jason Harper alongside Tom Bell, a Friday the 13th, and one of my favorite holidays. I call it a holiday, Tom. May just be my name. The Chemics and the Chargers in a great game at halftime, a one-point lead for the Midland High Chemic. And prior to the game, Tom, we took a look at some keys to victory. Let's revisit those for the Dow High Chargers and see how they've done.
Okay, Kaylee Wasco needs to touch the ball on most possessions.
Hard to do when you're on the bench.
I would say, well, even when she was playing, I'd give them a C on that one. Don't let Van Sumeren set her feet. I'd give them a B+. On that one, and stop Skylar Howard in the paint. Up until the last minute or two, they're probably doing a B. They kind of failed at the end. They were about a D.
On the other side, the Midland High Chemics and what they had to do in the first half.
Avoid foul trouble, I'd give them an A. They've only had just a couple of personal fouls, and they've been spread out. Share the ball offensively. They've had a lot of players. Avoid foul trouble, an A. Share the ball offensively. They've had a lot of shot opportunities by everybody on the court. I'd go A- and stretch Dow's defense. They really haven't done a lot of that. I'd say a B or a B-. But as far as our own selected keys to victory, Midland High's winning that part and just winning the score by just 1 point.
And Midland really hasn't had to stretch Dow's defense. They've been able to work that outside inside. Dow High switching to a zone defense in the second quarter, which appeared to work better at first, but then Skylar Howard has been open for quite some time. There you take a look at one of the officials working the game. Sarah Sawyer preparing for the third quarter. Randy Hutton and James Lackley are the other officials. And speaking of officiating, if you're looking for something to do, high school officials, sports officials in every sport are greatly needed. You can go online to the MHSAA website to find out more information. You can give back to the game. Become a high school official. Here we go in the third quarter, and Ellie Taylor wasting no time getting the shot, but she does not get the friendly roll. And we're going to have the ball out of bounds and the possession staying with Dow High.
I'm old school, but that European step always throws me.
Macy Taylor, three-pointer, no good. Midland High will have the rebound. Chemics coming back the other direction. Maddie Berry working the ball at the top of the key for Midland, and Berry is going to be fouled. The question is if she was in the act of shooting or not.
I think she was. She was trying to drive and get the ball up.
Nadia Atten picking up the foul. And Maddie Berry will indeed go to the free throw line.
Maddie's pretty good at from the free throw line. This is her first attempt tonight.
You jinxed her.
Well.
You know the one thing I like about Maddie?
She's left-handed?
Absolutely.
Okay. Well, see if
lefty's got to stick together. But she misses both of the free throws. Ball goes out of bounds. It's going to stay Midland High basketball. Ellie Taylor thinking that it was last touched by Midland High, let the ball go. And
we had a real good shot at that, and I don't know who it was off of. So.
Well, according to James Lackley, it was off of Dow High.
We'll go with that, but I had no clue.
Midland High leading by one early on here in the third quarter. Inside of Skylar Howard. Howard backing back up. Can't get the shot to go. Nadia Atten will get the rebound for the Chargers. And we've got a carry called on Dow High. You don't see very much in the high school game. Molly Davis with the on-force turnover will give the ball right back to Midland.
Well, that's a call that is not made in AAU. You see a lot of players being able to do that, and they got to be careful. They'll bring some of those habits to the public schools.
Maddie Berry over to Hannah Smith. Back to Berry. Three-pointer, count it. Maddie Berry hits the three-pointer. First basket of the third quarter gives the Midland High Chemics a four-point lead.
And she has six for the night.
Ellie Taylor dribbling into the paint, and Taylor will go to the free throw line. This may be something that we see more of in the second half of Ellie Taylor trying to take more control and try to penetrate the basket more.
You know, and to have her go to the line certainly is in Dow's advantage. She shoots free throws exceptionally well.
A little communication between the officials on who was called for the foul. They're going to give it to Skylar Howard. As we mentioned, Ellie Taylor hitting the first free throw. She's a candidate for Miss Basketball in the state of Michigan. Will play Division I at St. Louis University next year.
And she committed a while ago. I think it was midway through her junior year. And she has nine for the evening.
Two-point Midland High lead, 6:45 to go here in the third quarter. The pace of the second half a little bit slower than what we saw the first half. Very rambunctious, very back and forth.
Well, Wasco is taking a lot more attention to Howard.
Hannah Smith over to Van Sumeren, back to Smith. Smith being double teamed for the go inside of Skylar Howard, but Molly Davis coming up with the steal for the Dow High Chargers. Ellie Taylor with the basketball, back to Davis. A lot of basketballs are dribbled between the Taylor and the Davis household. Inside, Kaylee Wasco can't get the shot to go, and Midland High will come back the other direction. Bodies hitting the floor at midcourt as Maddie Berry cannot get the shot to go for Midland High. Now Saginaw Valley basketball, a little more physical than what you see in some of the divisions. Three-pointer by Ellie Taylor, no good, but Davis is there to get the rebound. Did she shuffle her feet? Not according to the referee.
Well, Taylor's got some points, but she's only hit one three.
Molly Davis, three-pointer, no good. Ball is loose on the ground. Everybody going for it, still everybody going for it. Midland High will come away with it.
And they've got five on one.
And they come up empty-handed. Hannah Smith was trying to draw the foul. Now Alex Van Sumeren misses a three-pointer. Things getting a little out of control, a little physical, and Right now, I think if you're both coaches, you want to just try to slow the pace down a little bit. Great hustle. Hannah Smith had unbelievable hustle for Midland. Maisie Taylor had great hustle for Dow. But all of it, no point scored for either team.
Yeah, I don't think that all the Chemics knew it was 5-on-1 at that point. I think a couple that were way down the court didn't know that they had three teammates right behind them.
Inside for Wasco. Get the bucket, her first basket since the first quarter. Kaylee Wasco ties the game up. 28-28, 4:45 to play in the third quarter.
And Wasco needs to be more of the offense.
Three-pointer no good by Jordan Phillips. The putback is no good. Ellie Taylor will come away with the ball. Midland has had so many three-point shots in this game, but they've only hit about two or three of them compared to the number of shots that they have taken. Maisie Taylor inside to Wasco, count the bucket. Maisie Taylor playing great for the Dow High Chargers, and Elaine Mahabier is going to call her third timeout, stopping the clock at 4:17. The momentum beginning to go in the favor of the Chargers. As you take a look at the Dow High bench, they've got a two-point lead. There's head coach Kyle Tyson.
And I think he's got to be happy about how his girls are able to make something out of not very much. They get a deflection, and then they look up, and there's Wasco underneath the basket.
Elaine Mahabier talking to the Midland High Chemics.
And for the Chemics, right now they've only seen Maddie Berry with a three in this quarter. They need to get a little more into Howard and with Van Sumeren. And we're seeing a little bit of a press, I don't know, a man-to-man press maybe?
Now the Midland High Chemics.
That's on Wasco.
That is not what Wasco wanted to do at all, and she knew it immediately. And that is going to be the third foul on Kaylee Wasco, who really did not intend to make contact. She was running up to play defense, saw the pass coming, but definitely made the foul. So she's the only person in foul trouble.
And you wonder if Wasco, Howard just slowed down.
Well,
I'm not sure.
If she did, that was a great move on her part.
Yeah.
Sammy Van Sumeren back in the game for the Midland High Chemics. She's got the ball right now. Now they go back inside to Howard, who gives it to Smith. Smith can't get the shot to go, but the rebound by Midland. Maddie Berry, three-pointer, count it. From the top of the key, Maddie Berry hitting the three. She's got 9 points for Midland High, and the Chemics are back on top by one.
And her shot is looking better and better as this game has progressed. She's a good shooter to begin with, but she's really finding her spot.
Wasco has to go back out. Couple of dribbles by Molly Davis. Working over to Maisie Taylor. Back to Ellie Taylor. Ellie taking a couple of dribbles, being guarded by Alex Van Sumeren. Now Molly Davis back to Ellie. Ellie will go baseline. And a foul is going to be called.
Yes, that's Hannah Smith might get called for that one.
Smith picking up the foul. I really think that's a key that Ellie wants to take advantage of, is to drive that basket more.
Yeah, because with her at the free throw line, like we said a couple minutes ago, it may give Dow a chance to get a little offense. A few points on the board as they're trying to find an offense that's going to be effective.
You think, you wonder how many thousands of free throws she has practiced already in her life?
Undoubtedly, thousands upon thousands.
They're paying off. She's perfect from the free throw line, and Dow High's on top, 32-31. 3 minutes to go here in the third quarter.
Now Tyson has decided to go with Wasco. Is still playing, three fouls in the third quarter.
Berry can't get the shot to go. Howard with a great rebound, but the putback is no good. Ball goes out of bounds. It'll be Midland High basketball.
Now Dow's going to be in a big amount of hurt if Wasco gets her fourth foul here in the third frame. She may not see the court till the middle of the fourth quarter. She's really got to protect herself.
If you're Midland, do you try to go inside, try to draw that fourth foul? Sammy Van Sumeren, her shot is high, out of bounds. Dow High basketball.
I was pointing Midland, I didn't know. It went off the back of a player, I think.
You were just guessing.
Absolutely.
The official knew all along.
Well, yeah. You can but hope.
Maisie Taylor working inside to Kaylee Wasco. Great pass to Ellie Taylor, who completes the layup. Dow High with a three-point lead, 2:05 to go. Ellie Taylor now 13 points on the game for the Chargers. Smith tried to go inside, almost knocked away by Atten. Atten is one of those players for Dow High, doesn't get the press that some of the other players do, but she definitely brings it defensively. You know, we talk about the scoring that Dow High has and the number of offensive weapons, but they're also a very good defensive team.
They are. I mean, these are good athletes. They understand the game, and they've played in some high-pressure situations earlier this year, maybe not as of late. They've had a little easier competition last couple of games, but this is the same unit that was playing top-notch basketball last year, and everybody was a year younger. They're good athletes.
The Midland High cheerleaders, the Midland High Chemics, the Dow High Chargers, girls basketball here on MPS-TV. That timeout called by Kyle Tyson of Dow High. Also this weekend, boys basketball with the Chemics and Chargers. We've got wrestling coming your way as well. And then as we enter into the later months of winter, we've got hockey and swimming coming your way. Midland High to Maddie Berry, out to Alex Van Sumeren. Van Sumeren only has had 2 3-pointers, one of those setting the Chemic record earlier today for most 3-pointers in a career.
Now, if you notice, Dow is spending a lot more time on the arc defensively.
Is that a foul on Wasco?
I think that's number 4.
It is. Kyle Tyson doesn't agree with it, but Kaylee Wasco has just picked up foul number 4, and that is going to bring the substitution, and Asia Blanton will come back into the game. But Kaylee Wasco, 4 fouls here with 1:26 to go in the third quarter. Double teaming, and Midland throws it away. Expected somebody to be there. She wasn't.
I think Hannah thought that Skylar Howard was going to be there, and Skylar went into the paint.
Ellie Taylor into the paint, now works it back out. Asia Blanton off the bench, count the bucket. Blanton, who returned from the concussion protocol this week for the Dow High Chargers, showing that she can get it done offensively. Skylar Howard answering the call. Without Wasco on defense, Howard may be the weapon that Midland High wants to use.
And Howard's got some range with her arms too, which is a real advantage.
Chargers nearly threw the ball away. Ellie Taylor made the save. Now Maisie Taylor with the 3-pointer, no good. Rebound by Midland. Under a minute to go here in the third quarter, and we've got a foul called. Maisie Taylor is going to pick up the foul.
Was it a hand check? It was hard to tell.
The 4th foul on the Dow High Chargers as Midland High brings Jordan Phillips back into the game. Dow High brings Paige Messick in. Messick is a sophomore role player for the Chargers. Maddie Berry, 3-pointer, no good. Rebound, it's going to be Messick that brings it down for the Chargers. 25 seconds on the clock. Ellie Taylor going into the paint. Good hesitation by Ellie. Can't get the shot to go. Maddie Berry with the rebound. Clock down to 17 seconds. Midland's got plenty of time to try to tie the game up. Maddie Berry working it over to Hannah Smith. 3-pointer, count it. With 7 seconds to go in the third quarter, the game is tied. At the buzzer, long shot. Molly Davis could have taken about 3 more dribbles. There was enough time. The half-court shot doesn't go, and we are all tied up here in the third quarter, 36-36. A great high school basketball game here on MPS-TV. And if you're just tuning in and you want to know the dates and times to check out this game in its entirety, it will be shown on the MCTV channels, which is channel 99 if you have AT&T U-verse. It is channel 190 on Charter Communications, and the playback time's right there, 8 o'clock in the morning and then 8 o'clock at night, both Saturday and Sunday. For more times, be sure to check out the MidlandPS.org website. That's the Midland Schools website. And you can also check out the game within the next week on YouTube in high definition. So we go to the Midland Public Schools YouTube channel, and you can watch the game there. Lots of ways to watch the contest if you are a subscriber of Charter or AT&T UVerse, or if you've got a computer, you can watch the game.
Well, you know, Kaylee Wasco has only scored 6 points, but she's really dictated the flow of the game even when she's been off the court. That Dow was starting to expand the lead. 36-31, she left, Midland got hot. And it's now tied 36-36 going into the final frame. And I don't know how long Wasco will be on the bench.
Maddie Berry can't get the shot to go. Ellie Taylor will have the rebound for the Chargers. Working ahead to Maisie. She goes into the paint. Nice move. Can't get the bucket to go. Everything but the basket. Now Midland High's got a numbers advantage as Howard works it over to Alex Van Sumeren. Three-pointer from the corner for Van Sumeren, and the Chemics take the lead. Van Sumeren has got 9 points on the night. Maisie Taylor over to Asia Blanton. Blanton's got no place to go, so she goes back to Maisie. Working, tried to go inside, but the pass behind the intended receiver. So the Midland High Chemics will come away with the ball knocked out of bounds, and it will be Midland High basketball. Great defense by Maisie. Maisie Taylor reminds me a lot of Kristen Taylor.
Oh, yes. Okay. Well, rightly so.
I think.
Rightly so.
Maisie, mom and daughter. Maisie reminds me more of mom than what Ellie does.
Okay.
Working inside, Skylar Howard into the paint for the Midland High Chemics. Howard's got 10 points on the night. The Chemics with a 5-point lead.
And Midland has scored the last 10 points, and look who we have coming back into the game. But Kaylee Wasco.
Ellie Taylor with the ball now for Dow. Works it back out over to Molly Davis. 3-pointer, top of the key, no good. Rebound by Midland. Skylar Howard has been getting it done on both ends for the Midland High Chemics. Shot there by Berry, no good. Trying to follow it up was Midland High Jordan Phillips, and we're on the ground. Jump ball called, possession arrow in favor of Dow.
Fumble recovery.
And Kaylee Wasco does indeed check back into the game. And Elaine Mahabier, it's Dow High. Kyle Tyson is going to call the timeout for the Dow High Chargers. 6:08 to play here in the fourth quarter. Midland High leading 41-36 over the Dow High Chargers. A great high school basketball game here on MPS-TV. We reset what we have. Possession arrow will now be in favor of Midland High after they inbound the ball. The Chemics with 2 timeouts. The Chargers will have 3 timeouts remaining. There's a great look at Kyle Tyson talking to the Dow High Chargers. Dow High playing from behind, which is not something that they've been used to.
Yep, well, they've had that one game with Country Day, a long way from home, character builder. This is going to add to their resume if they pull this out. But they've been outscored 10-0. And you've got Wasco inside, and you think Midland is aware that Wasco is on the court right now?
You better believe it.
I think that's what first thing Elaine was talking about, was that we're going to go at her.
Still a lot of time to play in this contest. 5-point game. Right now, it's the Chemics that have the lead. Ellie Taylor looking to cut that deficit down, but the three-pointer is no good. Skylar Howard will get the rebound. Howard fishes it out at the last second at Jordan Phillips. Three-pointer! From the side, Jordan Phillips hitting the three for the Midland High Chemics. She's got 6 points on the game for Midland High. The Chemics have their biggest lead of the contest.
And I think those points are kind of a surprise to both Dow and maybe even to Jordan in the game. She's a good athlete playing freshman, but the other girls are the ones that get the prime shots.
Inside to Kaylee Wasco. Turn move, spin move, goes back the other direction, and she traveled. Great call. She went one way, she went the other way. And Randy Hutton, who's one of the best high school basketball officials in the state, has worked many college games, has worked many state finals, right there to make the call.
And Dow has given up their zone. They're playing man-to-man now. They can't allow Midland to just stand outside and shoot.
Midland High slowing down the pace as Maddie Berry works the ball. Lost her, dribbling a little bit, and a 5-second call is going to be called. She lost her balance, and that once she recovered, there was no way she was going to pass the ball to anybody being defended that closely.
Well, there wasn't any time to do her Curly Neal impression of Harlem Globetrotters at that point.
Ellie Taylor, no, we've got an offensive foul. That's on Kaylee Wasco. Kaylee Wasco has fouled out of the game with 4:37 to play. One of the leading players for the Dow High Chargers heading to the bench. Wasco is headed to New York for college. She averages 24 points the last game. Kyle Tyson is not happy at all, letting Randy Hutton know he disagrees with the call. And that is huge with 4.5 minutes to go. There is no Kaylee Wasco.
Anytime you elevate your elbow, they're going to call it.
And you see right there, Kyle Tyson is still having a discussion with Randy about that call.
Dow's got an uphill battle, but they've got shooters and scorers. They can do this.
Ellie Taylor working the ball now for the Dow High Chargers. Over to Molly Davis. Davis taking a couple of dribbles, switching her direction, and we've got a foul called again. Is that a foul going against? Oh, that's going to be against Midland. That's going to be against Phillips.
Okay.
So Jordan Phillips picking up the foul. Ellie Taylor, three-pointer, no good. Skylar Howard with the rebound. And all by themselves, two on nobody. Count the basket. Maddie Berry getting the shot in for Midland High. And the Chemics have a 10-point lead with 4 minutes to go.
And the Chargers have not scored in about four to five minutes.
Now, Ellie Taylor did not score that time around. The foul was before the basket. That is going to be the sixth foul on, maybe it's only the fifth foul on Midland High. Second one on Alex Van Sumeren. Asia Blanton is going to get a lot of playing time the last 3.5 minutes of this contest. Ellie Taylor with the ball for Dow High. Goes inside to Blanton, and she'll get the bucket and the foul. Now, when you get a chance, this is where great players make the most of opportunities, and Asia Blanton looking to do just that if she attempts a three-point play.
Well, and you're never quite sure, you know, how much practice she's missed with the concussion.
Made it the rebound and the putback. Nadia Atten, right place at the right time. And we're back to a 6-point game, 3:20 to go. And we've got a whistle away from the ball. I believe that's Nadia Atten that is going to pick up the foul. The officials have kind of tightened the reins a little bit on the stuff going on away from the ball.
Yeah, well, I think that the Chargers are trying to keep Howard away from the basket, or at least lower block. And they've gotten called with a little bit too much physical play there.
Now, Midland High will now be in the bonus for the final 3:15 of this game. Alex Van Sumeren with the ball for Midland High. Skyler Howard working down into the paint. Howard with a beautiful drive, can't get the bucket to go, but a foul will be called. Hannah Smith attempting the rebound, and Smith will go to the free throw line.
Now, Hannah's a junior, and she's starting to learn that when you muscle the ball up to the basket, good things happen.
In and out, no good from the free throw line. Hannah Smith, a very unselfish player. In fact, you could say that about any of the five on the floor. Really, you could say that about anybody on the floor for either the Chemics or the Chargers. Both of these teams, they want to win, and they're going to try to go to the best person to make that happen. Both of these teams play great unselfish basketball.
Well, if these girls weren't team players, they wouldn't be playing.
7-point Midland High lead, 3 minutes to go. Dow High with three timeouts, Midland High has two. Possession arrow favors the Chargers. Ellie Taylor with the ball. Aja Blanton back to Ellie, who's in the corner. Ellie Taylor will work it back around to Molly Davis, who thought about the shot. Davis has been very quiet here in the second half. Maisie Taylor with the ball, 2.5 minutes to go. Dow High has burned 30 seconds and have not even attempted a shot.
Midland's defense is very tough.
And how about a block? Hannah Smith underneath, and a foul will be called. But a great job by Hannah Smith coming up with the block, but then the foul happened in the battle for the basketball. Both teams will now be in the bonus. Basket count at Nadia Atkin, the senior, with only her second basket of the game. 5-point game, 2:10 to go. We expected a great one, we've got it. Maddie Berry, 3-pointer, no good. Maisie Taylor with the rebound.
I think Barry was surprised. She was so open on that one.
Maisie splitting apart the Chemic defense, but she can't get the shot to go. Skyler Howard will get the rebound. Maddie Berry, beautiful pass. Hannah Smith, bucket. 49-42, 1:35 to play.
Very unselfish play by the Chemics.
Molly Davis, 3-pointer, count it. And Kyle Tyson will call a timeout with 1:30 on the clock. It is a 4-point Midland High lead.
That was a very, very important response by Molly Davis to hit that shot. Now Kyle's got some stuff to talk about. We're down by only four. Here are some things we've got to do. You know, continue to play tough man-to-man defense. For Midland High, the only way that they're scoring is to break through, and then teams will overplay on the strong side with that bounce pass underneath the basket. But both teams are playing very, very strong man-to-man defenses right now.
There you see the Charger fan section. There's Kyle Tyson talking to the Dow High players. This is only the first of two meetings between these two teams. There's the Midland High fans that are in attendance. You ever wonder what happens to old basketball jerseys? That's what happens.
They're supposed to turn those things in at the end of the season, I thought.
I think those are the old, old ones.
Bought at rummage sales. Huh?
Yeah, well, some of those jerseys are from back when you were the JV coach at Dow High.
Oh, my gosh. Okay. Yeah, some girls never did show up with their uniforms at the end of the season.
Both teams have two timeouts. Possession arrow in favor of Dow. 90 seconds to play. Midland High leading by four. And the Chargers with the basketball. Wide open. Ellie Taylor. Three-pointer. Count it. Ellie Taylor has made this a one-point game, hitting the three-pointer from the corner. knocked away. It will remain Midland High basketball.
Well, Taylor and Davis have scored the last 6 points for the Chargers and has really closed this gap.
Skylar Howard with the ball, 1:10 on the clock. Howard driving into the paint, now goes to Van Sumeren. Working it over for a three-pointer, Jordan Phillips, no good. Rebound by the Chargers, and a reach-in foul will be called against the Chemics. The foul will be called on Phillips, and it will be a one-and-one situation that will send the Chargers to the free throw line with a chance to tie it or take the lead with 60 seconds to play. And Elaine Mahabir is going to call a timeout before Nadia Atten can shoot the free throws. Midland will have one timeout left. 101 is what is on the clock. 1 point game in favor of Midland High.
It did look like Nadia was going to take advantage of this rest. She was a little shook up. I'm not sure how well she was prepared to take those free throws. So when Elaine called timeout, all was good. Well, again, we're within 1 or 2 points. We thought just a minute ago that Midland had all of the momentum. And Dow comes storming back, and their fans there are appreciative of what they've just seen.
Now the momentum shift may be going in favor of the Dow High Chargers. Obviously, Midland looking to put a stop to that. At one time, Midland High had a 10-point lead. That's the biggest lead that anybody has had in this game.
And this last few seconds of the game, what are we looking at? 1:01. We're going to look at full court pressure by Dow, and it'll be returned if Dow gets a lead.
Nadia Atten, the senior, ties the game up. Atten had 11 points against Lapeer last Friday, and she has a chance to give the Chargers the lead on this free throw. And she does. Dow High takes a 1 point lead with 1:01 to go, and the Chargers showing a press, and the Hail Mary pass is gonna be intercepted by Atten. And we've got a timeout called by Kyle Tyson with 57 seconds to go. Each team will now have one timeout remaining.
Well, probably not the best choice. I don't think that Midland High had an option to go long. They just have to work harder getting open on the high percentage passes. That point, but Dow's got the ball, and if Dow tries to stall a little bit, Midland High's got to make a decision: booty or foul.
Now, neither team has any fouls to give. It will be a 1-1 if anybody goes to the line, as the two respective coaches, Kyle Tyson and Elaine Mahabir, earn their money here. But these are the games that you live for if you're a coach.
Oh yeah, and this is where your team grows, because Midland High has played some games that have not been very close recently, and Dow High the same way. You know, they love the opportunity to get these girls challenged, and that's how they get better. But they're really showing how well matched up they really are. And Midland High really hasn't taken the kind of advantage with Wasco out of the game, but they've really highlighted Ellie Taylor in hitting some layups and hitting some free throws.
Chargers lead by one. 50 seconds to go. Molly Davis with the ball. Chemex have to come up on defense, force Davis to do something. Davis switching directions.
Got to be careful she doesn't palm it. Got called for that earlier.
35 seconds to go. How long do you wait if you're Midland before you foul? Beautiful screen there by Nadia Atten. And there's a foul that, no, I don't think a foul. Kyle Tyson calls his last timeout.
Okay.
So 28 seconds to go. The Chargers will now be out of timeouts, but Dow High burning off about 30 seconds of game time. And that has got to be the, an advantage here.
Yeah, we're looking at the trainer working.
We're looking at Elaine Mahabier talking to the Midland High Chemics on what to do.
Yeah.
In the final 28 seconds of this contest, but it's interesting to note, however, that Hannah Smith is being worked on the sideline.
It looks like a muscle cramp in her lower leg.
So Hannah Smith is not in the game for Midland High. There's the foul. Chargers have the, you're gonna send somebody to the free throw line if you're in Midland, but you almost have to. You had to stop the clock with 23 seconds to go. Alex Van Sumeren will pick up her third foul. Ellie Taylor will go to the free throw line. Not sure Ellie is who you wanted to foul.
No, but if she's the only one that's gonna have the ball, you run out of choices.
Midland High will use their final timeout. 51-49. Dow High still has one more free throw to go. An exciting finish to the Midland Dow girls basketball game. Don't forget boys basketball and high school wrestling also coming your way here on MPS-TV this weekend. And all of these games will be available on MPS's YouTube channel in high definition.
Now, when this game is over with, I think Kyle Tyson is going to be very surprised how well his team stayed in the game, down by 10, and without its all Saginaw Valley center, Kaylee Wasco, getting her fifth foul. But winners find a way to win. And Midland High has a bunch of winners on their team, too. They may find an opportunity here. If Taylor misses this shot, they've got themselves a two-point deficit. And Midland High has a bunch of three-point shooters here. We could have an exciting finish.
Dow High playing without Kaylee Wasco. She fouled out in the third quarter. Midland High playing without Hannah Smith, who has suffered a leg injury. Allie Taylor has not missed a free throw all game long. Dow High leading by three. 23 seconds to go. Chemics looking to tie, possibly force overtime. Clock down to 15. Sammy Van Sumeren with the ball. Works it over to Jordan Phillips. 10 seconds to go. Phillips to Alex Van Sumeren. Alex takes a couple of dribbles. She's being guarded very closely by Davis. Trying to go inside. Maisie Taylor coming up with a steal. Jump ball called. Possession arrow is in favor of Midland High. But there's only 1.7 seconds. Midland needs a three-pointer in 1.7 seconds to force overtime. No timeouts. And a foul! A foul was called, and Midland High will have to go to the free throw line with 7/10 of a second to try to tie this game up.
Well, I coached at Northeast where Alex Van Sumeren went to school, and Alex was by far the best free throw shooter I've ever coached.
You talk about pressure. Earlier tonight, she set a new record for most three-pointers, but it's the free throws now. Alex Van Sumeren on the free throw line for Midland. First free throw is good. Nerve of steel has got to be what Alex Van Sumeren is feeling.
As long as she just takes it one at a time and relaxes, she's got a great stroke.
I don't think you could book it any better than what we have now. Alex Van Sumeren has a chance to tie the game on the free throw line with 7/10 of a second to go. possession by Strider. Howard had the chance for the putback. Dow rebounds, and the Chargers win by one. Oh my, Tom Bell, what a finish here tonight. Oh my.
You know,
heartbreaking for Alex Van Sumeren and the Midland High Chemics. What a game, Tom.
And who was supposed to block out Howard? Howard had a chance to put the puck back in to win the game. What a finish.
The Dow High Chargers coming away with a 52-51 victory here tonight. Kyle Tyson and the Dow High Chargers improving to 8-1. They remain a perfect 5-0 in the Saginaw Valley. The Midland High Chemics will drop down to 6-3 with the loss. The Dow High Chargers at one point trailed by 10. Without Kaylee Wasco, they were able to fight back and take the lead. And at the very end, Alex Van Sumeren missing the free throw. The rebound putback was no good by Skylar Howard, and the Dow High Chargers coming away with a one-point victory. Tom, quickly, your final thoughts on an amazing basketball game.
Well, that last free throw that Van Sumeren shot just looked like her follow-through was a little tighter. But, you know, Howard had a chance to win it, too, at that point. But for Dow, the senior leadership with L.A. Taylor, I think, was huge when Wasco had to sit down. She distributed the ball. She made free throws. She hit a three. She was a big part of it at the very end.
Absolutely. Obviously, Ellie Taylor played well. Maisie Taylor had a great game. Nadia Atten at the end had a couple of big plays for the Chargers as well. And the Dow High Chargers, they do what good teams do. They do what great teams do. They found a way to win tonight.
Yeah, and I think that Kyle is kind of shocked that he's walking out of this gym still with only one loss. And boy, this sets up the rematch over at Dow High.
No doubt about that. A great basketball game here. We're glad that you are with us on MPS-TV. In a couple of moments, you're going to see several names come across your screen. If you know any of those individuals, be sure to thank them for making high school sports possible here on MPS-TV. For Tom Bell and our entire MCTV crew, my name is Jason Harper. The final score tonight, the Dow High Chargers defeat Midland High 52-51. Good night.